myself in times of trouble. Mother Mary comes to me, speaking the words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking the words of wisdom, let it be. Let it be. Whisper word of wisdom, let it be. Hey, how's it going, guys? Welcome back to Clive's English Corner, and welcome to a new episode of Rockstar English. You guys know what we do here at Rockstar English, where we take our favorite songs and we try to extract what these songs do with this beautiful language we call English. So, you guys know the song, right? Right? You know it, right? Seriously? The Beatles? No? I think I'm old. But in all seriousness, guys, don't forget to smash the like button on this video and drop a comment for the next song you would like me to cover and extract that good information from it in another episode of Rockstar English. So why let it be? Very simple, you guys. First of all, I would like to talk about imperatives. Imperatives? What are you talking about, bruh? In plain English, these are sentences we use to request something, to give a command, or ask for a favor. So, for example, if I say, sit down, get up, or bring me the newspaper, or whatever action or verb that you would like to use, that basically is an imperative. Have in mind that imperatives do not have any pronouns, so you don't need to actually refer to the person you are giving this command to, because in most times it is obvious who you are addressing. Of course, in some situations you may say something like, Maria, please bring me the notebook, right? Or John, pass me the ketchup, please. So those sentences, I am making sure the person who is going to be accepting this request is, you know, sure that I'm addressing him or her. But in an imperative, you do not need pronouns or names. So basically, the imperative in the song is let it be. Let it be, just let it be, okay? So it's telling the listener to just go with the flow. Let it be, don't stress out. Let it be, guys. So now that we know what's an imperative and how they use it in the song, again, let it be. Just let it be, bro. Let it be, okay? So that would be the imperative, right? But that's not the whole story in this song. There's something else that is quite useful, guys, and those are dependent clauses.
Oh no, grammar again, please.
Don't worry. A dependent clause, guys, is basically one of those phrases or sentences that just by itself can't communicate an idea. So, in the song, there is a phrase that says, when I find myself in times of trouble, that's the starting line of the song. So if I just let it die there and I say, when I find myself in times of trouble, that wouldn't make any much sense, that, right, guys? So in that sense, when you use words like when, if, although, those words that make your sentence kind of suspended, needing of a consequent or a following idea in order to make sense, that would be a dependent clause. And so the rest of the song is plagued with this type of sentences. So if we take another phrase in the song as an example of a dependent clause, We can say, for though they may be parted. That's quite fancy, isn't it? But in all seriousness, guys, well, at the end of the day, this song was written by an English person, Paul McCartney, so that's why it has this kind of fancy phrase, right? But this type of sentence, again, can't communicate an idea by itself. For though they may be parted, they can still influence us, or they can still enjoy, or we will join them in the afterlife, who knows? But you need that next idea in order to make sense. Another example would be, and when the broken-hearted people living in the world agree, what happens afterwards? There will be an answer, right? So you always have this game of tension and release when you have a complex sentence, or dependent sentence and a independent sentence, which is the full idea, the complete idea. I go, I play the guitar, I eat pizza, I like to play tennis, etc. Okay? But those sentences, like, when I travel, if I go, you see my point? They don't make much sense unless I completed the idea. For instance, when the weather was terrible, the game was suspended. Okay? Although there was sunny weather, they didn't go to the beach. So again, the first part of a sentence can't make much sense unless you have the next following phrase or sentence. Well, it has to be a sentence, actually, a full sentence with a subject, verb and complement, okay? So that is pretty much the style of sentence that is being used in this song. So let's listen to that song, shall we?
Myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking a word of wisdom, let it be. And in my heart of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking a word of wisdom, let it be. Hearted people living in the world agree, there will be an answer, let it be. Well, they may be parted, there is still a chance that they will see, there will be an answer, let it be. Let it be. Let it be, let it be. There will be an answer. Let it be. 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 Whisper words of wisdom. Let it be. Yo, let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Whisper words of wisdom. Let it be. When the night is cloudy, there is still a light that shines on me. Shine until tomorrow, let it be. I wake up to the sound of music. Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom. Let it be. 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 There will be an answer. Let it be. Yo, let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. There will be an answer. Let it be. 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 Whisper words of wisdom. Let it be.
So you guys, if you enjoyed this video, if you enjoyed the song, please leave a like, drop a comment with the song you would like me to cover next or the topic you would like me to cover next. If you have any doubts about something you would like to learn or improve, I'm here to help you. And remember to smash the like button, remember to subscribe, drop a comment, share it with a friend that might need this video or might like this video to learn while they enjoy some music. And I'll see you guys in the next episode of Rockstar English. See you guys next time.